What is non-ionizing radiation? Any type of electromagnetic wave that doesn't carry enough energy to completely remove an electron from an atom or molecule. So this ionizing, non-ionizing radiation is not harmful for our body, as it doesn't have much energy to completely remove an electron from an atom or molecule. So the different types of non-ionizing radiations are lower ultraviolet ray, visible light, infrared ray, microwave, radio wave, etc. What is non-ionizing radiation? So the radiation that carries enough energy to free electrons from atoms and molecules. So you can see this is the radiation which we should care about. This is very harmful for our body tissue, as it has a higher energy which can free electrons from atoms or molecules. The examples of ionizing radiations are gamma rays, X-rays, IR, ultraviolet rays, etc. So the electromagnetic waves which are used in imaging are X-rays, visible light, gamma rays, radio frequency waves, etc. This is the first X-ray image of Roentgen's wife, Bartha. So before starting the X-ray fundamentals, I would like to discuss about X-ray tube. What are the components in an X-ray tube? We all know the X-ray tube has one evacuated glass, one cathode material, anode material, and high voltage electric source. So this cathode and anode and it is placed inside the evacuated envelope. Why we place this in an evacuated envelope? Because it is to control the number and speed of accelerated electrons independently, so that the outer atmospheres which cannot be hampered this situation, like the things that can control this process from outer atmosphere, like humidity or other electromagnetic waves. So these things can hamper the control, the number of process and accelerated electrons independently. Pyrex glass we use as a envelope, as a glass envelope. So cathode. So cathode is a negative terminal in the X-ray tube. There are cathode along with two cathode filament we have in modern day X-ray tubes. Along with two filament, the other elements are conducting wires and focusing curve. Filament made of tungsten wire, 0.2 millimeter in diameter, coiled to a form of vertical spiral, 0.2 centimeter diameter and 1 centimeter in length. What is focusing curve? Focusing curve is a shallow depression in containing the filament, which is made of molybdenum. The filament emits electron, all of which have a negative charge. Since negative repels negative, the electrons that have been emitted have a tendency to diverge. So the electrons which we produce are the negative charge electrons. So we all know that negative repels negative. So it has a tendency or negatively charged housing, which encourages the electrons to stay together. Essentially, the force that causes the electrons to repel each other is overpowered by repulsive force of the focusing curve, and the electrons tend to converge rather than diverge. So we can maintain the flow in one direction, but if we don't use the focusing curve, then the flow will be diverged in many directions. Negative plus negative. So filament. Modern tubes have two filament. So we use tungsten as a filament for. Tungsten, it has a high atomic number, 74. So the melting point is 33,070 degrees Celsius. So in that high melting point, it has a less tendency to vaporize. So the tungsten is a function of the tungsten is it is a strong high melting point, less tendency to vaporize, and long life expectancy. So anode. Before start, I would like to discuss about the what is the principle of a tube, of a X-ray tube. So extra tube, previously we have a tetraode extra tube, but modern day we have a rotating anode extra tube. What happened inside a tube? An extra tube is a evacuated an electron tube that produces X-ray by accelerating electrons to a high velocity with a high voltage field and causing them to collide with a target, that is anode plate. So in anode, here we can see the two types of X-ray tube we have. One is stationary anode and another is rotating anode. Previously, stationary anode tubes were used, but in modern day we use very rotating anode extra tube. So why we use rotating anode extra tube today in modern day? Because a considerable heat is generated in the focal spot. So a rotating anode lets the electron beam sweep a larger area of the anode. So the heat can be sweep in a larger area, and it will increase the expected life expectancy of the anode material. So here you can see in the stationary anode, one tungsten target is used, and where a copper shielding is placed behind this tungsten target. And let me use the highlighter. And cathode terminal is here. There is a window where X-ray beam will flow from there in this window. This is the envelope, glass envelope, and this is a copper anode. So why copper is used behind the target tungsten target? Because this in stationary anode, to dissipate that heat, we use copper. Copper can transfer the heat to the outer side. So to increase the life expectancy of that tungsten target, we use copper as an outer shell. So this is rotating anode. So as I previously discussed, what happens in a tube, in an X-ray tube, a tungsten filament is heated by electric current, and it releases negatively charged electrons by thermionic effect. Due to high voltage potential difference between cathode and anode, the electrons are thus accelerated and hit the anode target. So here you can see also, this is the anode target and this is the cathode end, where these things has been placed inside an evacuated glass. This anode is connected with the anode rotor, which is a induction motor to rotate the anode. This is the output port. Here, transformer oil is used as a coolant, because enormous heat is generated inside this tube. And in both sides, a high voltage electric source is connected in both sides of cathode and anode. This is a modern day rotating anode X-ray tube. This looks like this. So I discussed about the thermionic effect. What happened when tungsten filament heated by electric current, and it releases negatively electrons by thermionic effect. What is thermionic effect? So thermionic effect is when the current flows where heated, it absorbs thermal energy. So and the electrons move a small distance from a surface to metal. Thermionic of emission of electrons resulting from the absorption of thermal energy is called thermionic emission. Due to this thermionic emission, the negatively charged electrons it floats from the negative charge end to positive charged end. So I would like to discuss about the line focus principle now. The effective focal spot is the beam projected onto the patient. As the anode angle decreases, the effective focal spot decreases. So let me present, use the pointer. In this image, this is A and this is image B. in image A, you can see we use 24 degree anode angle, and in image B, you can see we use 12 degree anode angle. Though the electron beam size is same in both the images, but due to the difference of this anode angle, the effective focal spot is changed. It is effective focal spot is higher than the focal spot. So it is inversely proportional. It is proportional, directly proportional. That if you increase the anode angle, the effective focal spot will increase. So diagnostic tube target angles range from 5 to 15 degree. So due to anode angle, we use 15 degree anode angle, and when the X-ray collide, when the electrons collide to the anode, it travels through an angle. So here Hill effect is causing them. What is Hill effect? The Hill effect is due to a portion of the X-ray beam being absorbed by the anode. This result in an X-ray beam that is less intense on the anode side and more intense on the cathode side. The Hill effect is more pronounced with steeper anode angle. So here in 15 degree angle, you can see X-ray emits in the anode side but the X-rays emitting in from the cathode in the cathode side, its intensity is higher. So if we when we do the lung sign or abdomen cases, we always put the patient position head in anode side and the foot in the cathode side because of this Hill effect. So in this side image, the X-ray penetration will be better compared to this anode side. So this is all the basic X-ray I would like to discuss today. This was is my last slide. If you have any queries, thank you so much.
Thank you, Arnab.